stories. So you want a horror story. Well, seeing how Frank here has seen his share of horror stories, the years of seeing the worst of the city, all the filth and scum that infest these streets at night, you may have a horror story or two to indulge that morbid fascination of yours. Frank Tenpringer, my friends, just your average cabbie, going on 23 years now, used to work the streets during the day. But seeing how times are hitting hard, the pay and tips not being enough for the bills, explains why Frank is working nights. It's when the sun goes down, the city shows its true face. Yeah, when you spend enough time on these streets at night, you see a lot, you hear a lot. There was this woman who used to work these streets at night. I think her name was Sarah. Well, supposedly Sarah was hitting hard times and was desperate in leaving the city. Even though Sarah was aware of the dangers of working these streets, the woman knew how to take care of herself. But on one night, I guess Sarah's street smarts was not enough. There was this customer who had his eye on Sarah. The man had a reputation. One of those sick freaks who were willing to spend a lot of money for certain requests. The kind of job that can not only have a girl making a lot of money, but ending up in the hospital or crippled for life. And well, Sarah ended up taking the risk and was found dead 3 days later. Her body was badly beaten, her face beyond recognition. Obviously, everyone knew it was murder, that Sarah was a victim to a fucking animal, and you would have thought that the guy had been arrested, making front page news. But seeing how this guy was related to the mayor of the city, Sarah's death was dismissed as an overdose. And as for the guy, he's still roaming these streets. Frank just passed him a few moments ago at Edinger before picking up these two kids. Frank will never understand why Sarah would do something like that, after knowing what she was walking into. He'll just never understand, just like this city. Fact is, Frank truly hates the city. These streets running wild with punks, psychos, and strung-out weirdos. Like these two kids he just picked up on the corner of 12th and Delancey. Young, rich, doped up and horny. Already fucking in the back seat. No destination, just drive. My girlfriend likes it fast, he says. Kids these days, why can't they just take their business in the back of a theater like they used to? But when seeing a wrinkled bill falling on the passenger seat with a request to drive faster, Frank had seen enough Franklins in his time to ease down on the pedal, watching the red dash needles slowly climb as the girl's moaning started to become more intense. With the moaning getting louder, the sounds of intense sexual intercourse behind Frank, memories, fantasies, and thoughts of coping with the situation flooding his mind. Pressure was now building up within Frank. Not the first time a girl was getting her bones jumped in his cab, and yet, this was different. A strange fear within Frank when hearing the guy asking him to go faster. It was like Frank was part of the ecstasy in the back seat. He was already going 40 in a city full of cab-hating cops, and feelings of reluctance being overpowered with a thick wad of Franklins hitting the passenger seat. And Frank, without thinking, stepped it up to 45 as beads of sweat started to come down on his face. The moaning got faster and louder. These fucking kids. God, how much Frank hated this city. An elderly man on crutches who had nearly died from a speeding cab, several drivers who had their lives flash before their eyes when nearly colliding with a cab that was swerving in and out of his lane, and eyewitnesses who saw a cab literally vandalize street signs, traffic lights, and whatever else was on the sidewalk, the horns blaring as the cab's speed had not even faltered. Faster and faster, and that fear within Frank was now growing as he could hear the intense passion in the girl's voice as she was practically begging him to go faster each time a wad of cash hitting the passenger seat. Frank didn't understand why he felt that he was the one in control. There was even an erection in his pants in response to the roaring engine and the girl's moaning. These fucking kids. God, Frank hated these kids. Hated the city because of how helpless he felt, and how he was somehow enjoying this and needing this because of the cash flying up front. They were now practically flying. This was obviously suicide, At this point, Frank wasn't even paying attention to the girl screaming and the money being thrown up front. He was now trying to survive, trying to find a way to reach the open country. If Frank can just reach the bridge, make his way past traffic, no cops, then he should be good. Look at Frank, trying to get out, trying to escape. The hands welded to the steering wheel, foot flat against the floor, the tightening pressure in between his legs, anticipating for that climatic ending, the horror show to finally come to an end. 70. Frank was now reaching 70. That's top end. That's as high Frank can go, in perfect speed. Out of the city now, flying through the midnight woods. The perfect speed, it was like Frank could feel the adrenaline coursing through their bodies. The erotic screams now begging Frank to keep it at that speed, reluctantly enjoying the sense of pleasuring this girl as the cash was still being thrown up front. All Frank could think about was the mounting bills, the crummy flat he has to go home to every night, another chance at life. To pick himself back up from rock bottom, an opportunity to leave the city after surviving this horror story, and how much Frank hated himself when realizing how desperate he was to escape, and the fact that he was enjoying this. God, if these sick kids would just finish up. Frank eagerly anticipating the moment for the begging and the screaming to cease. And just as the girl was about to come, that was when Frank saw the sign. That intense fear tightening his aged heart when seeing the words, "No through roads," flying right at him. And as Frank shoved his foot on the brake, losing control of the vehicle, the last thing Frank remembered was the sounds of crashing and the girl coming before the vehicle hit the tree. When Frank regained consciousness, there was no pain, just the night sky and the stars above, the smoke coming from the wreckage. Obviously, Frank knew that he was dying, caught a glimpse of himself on the dangling rearview mirror, not a pretty sight. And standing over him were the two kids, noticing that there was not a mark on them, both of them staring down at Frank. These sick fucking kids. The guy wanted Frank to know that even though it looks like he's dying, his girlfriend thinks he did real good. She really enjoyed that. And she also wanted to thank him. When everything started to go dark for Frank, the last thing Frank saw was these kids flagging down another cab. And the guy letting the cabbie know, his girlfriend likes it fast.